has more than 20 consecutive books on the New York Times bestseller list.
Fellas just bought yourself a boat trip.
One inspired the hit movie Sahara. He sold more than 150 million books in 40 languages in more than 100 countries. And it's his love of classic cars that brings him home to Arvada. I'm Wendy Brockman. I'm one-on-one with Clive Cussler, the grandmaster of the American action-adventure novel.
Been a wild ride.
A wild ride for both he and his well-known fictional hero, Dirk Pitt.
When Pitt and I started out together, we were both 36. Now he's probably about 42, 44, and I'm 73. And that ain't fair.
I sat down with the world-famous novelist at his car museum in Arvada. The part-time Colorado resident just opened his renowned collection to the public.
They're automotive masterpieces of art. Regardless what they're worth today, but come around like a Van Gogh in 200 years and they'll be worth $100 million because there's nothing to replace them.
They're all one of a kind.
Mm-hmm.
When Cussler's not writing a bestseller, he's scouring auctions around the globe for very rare cars, some worth $750,000. He has one of the top collections in the world, rivaling those of Jay Leno and Ralph Lauren.
I like them all for different reasons, you know, they're all sentimental in some way or another.
So many of these cars tell a story. This 46 Ford, for example, the first one in the collection. Clive saw it for sale at a farm in Longmont. It was just like the one his wife drove in high school. He bought it, restored it, and the hobby was born.
I restored it out in the street, practically. I sprayed it with, you know, primer cans, and then I had it postered and painted. But that was the first one of the collection.
They've been stored in a private museum here in Arvada for years. Now, with the help of his oldest daughter, Terry, the doors are open to everyone.
These cars have been in this building, the collection, for almost 20 years. And we've had car clubs occasionally come through and see them, but we just felt maybe it was time that the public got to really enjoy seeing them.
The Art Deco colors will catch your eye. Orange, burgundy, blue, and green. Reflections of Cussler's creativity.
And you call these colors Clive colors?
You know, they're not original colors, but yeah, I call them Clive colors. You know, back then, I mean, most of the cars were black, so, you know, who wants a room full of black cars? So, he's made it interesting.
At the recent grand opening, Cussler sees old friends and signs some autographs. He has a 30-year history in Colorado. Cussler and his wife Barbara raised their three children here, living in Estes Park, Golden, and Arvada. Daughter Terry and son Dirk graduated from Arvada High School.
So what are your favorite Arvada memories?
Gosh, well, it was funny driving around the other day. I still saw a lot of them here. Griff's Hamburgers is over there, and the Western Bowl is still there. So those are some of the old hangouts.
Sometimes he'd pile us all in one of the old cars we had and go to the drive-in. You know, all of us, even my sister was a baby, and we'd all be at the drive-in together.
They've grown up with the Dirk Pitt books. The character was named after Dirk's son, who was a toddler when Cussler started writing. The rest Cussler patterned after himself, including his love of cars, shipwrecks, and tequila.
At the time, I was 6'3" and weighed 185 pounds, so I used that. I gave him black hair. I was going to make him a blonde, and then I found out that women still preferred the dark type.
Cussler toiled away at the typewriter for years, writing at night, working for a Denver ad agency during the day to pay the bills. It was his breakout book, Raise the Titanic, in 1976 that finally put him on the map. After that, he never looked back.
You didn't think it was going to be that big?
Not a chance. And people would say, congratulations on overnight success. And I'd say, yeah, 11 years.
And then Hollywood came calling.
Yeah, they came calling and gave me a nice sum of money and then made this awful, awful movie. It was a real box office bomb.
The movie-making experience was so bad that Cussler refused to sell his movie rights again until 20 years later, when a script for Sahara came along.
The movie Sahara hit the big screen this summer based on a book written by part-time Colorado resident Clive Cussler. Back home to open his classic car museum, he sat down for an interview about his own action-packed lifestyle. After the box office bomb raised the Titanic based on his book 20 years ago, Clive was ready to try again, this time with script and casting approval.
Now, I read that for Sahara, you had envisioned Hugh Jackman.
Yeah, originally a Hugh Jackman, but he wanted to go back to New York to be in some play back there because he likes to sing. I looked at all the new heroes, you know, Heath Ledger and Clive Owen or something, Owen Wilson and Matt Dillon and all these guys, and they all look like they came out of a cookie cutter. What happened to the Humphrey Bogarts, the James Cagneys, the Stewarts, the Waynes? Matthew McConaughey came to the house twice pitching the role.
Really? He wanted it?
He wanted it bad.
But despite some creative control, the movie experience was not what Cussler envisioned. In fact, he's now involved in a lawsuit over the film and has yet to see the final product. Sahara may be the last Cussler-inspired movie, but not the last book. His son, Dirk, is taking over the Dirk Pitt tradition.
And I told him, I said, would you like to do a Pitt book? He said, oh my God, there's no way. And I says, you grew up with him. You know everything about him. So I worked with him, and he wrote Black Wind.
Dirk, with an MBA in business, was getting tired of his job at Motorola and had always thought about writing.
Well, I suppose just having a father as a writer, I suppose that was always in the back of my mind.
My agent and editor were scared to death because they thought that nepotism here, this will be a lousy book. And when they read it, they were dumbfounded. They said, my God, it's seamless. It's just like you can't tell where that you left off and he took over.
Is it strange to write about someone who was named after you? I mean, does it feel a little?
It is, and what makes it worse is now that he's brought in the Dirk Pitt's son, who's also named Dirk. I joke, there's too many Dirks involved here.
The books, they'll just continue on, like with another generational.
But it's a historic wreck, very historic. I mean, this is the legendary ghost ship of all time.
Colorado's own Clive Cussler, known mainly for his best-selling books, also loves to dig up real-life history. He's helped uncover more than 60 shipwrecks all over the world.
During the Pacific, when I was in the Korean conflict, we flew supplies over and then the wounded back, and every time we'd hit an island, I'd go diving.
That's when he became fascinated with sunken ships, including the Carpathia, the ship that rescued the Titanic survivors. It was torpedoed during World War I. Cussler and his team found the wreckage.
It's been great fun closing the chapter, I guess you'd call it, on a lot of these mysteries. Since I got hooked on this sort of search, we incorporated as a nonprofit, called it NUMA, which is the National Underwater and Marine Agency. It's the same one Dirk Pitt belongs to in the books.
No one else has been willing to fund these expensive trips, so Cussler does it himself.
My accountant, of course, thinks I belong in a rubber room under restraint, because there's no return other than satisfaction on any of this. We're preserving maritime history, you know. I guess I'm doing a service.
Cussler helped produce several documentaries on his finds. He also wrote two nonfiction books about these adventures, appropriately titled The Sea Hunters. They sum up his philosophy on life.
Get off that couch, go into the mountains, go into the deserts, go under the lakes, under the rivers and the seas, and search for history. You'll never find a more rewarding experience. This is ground control to Major Tom. You've really made the grade.
And the papers want to know whose shirts you wear.
So what's next for the famed author? His wife of 47 years, Barbara, died 2 years ago from cancer. She shared his passion for classic cars and lost shipwrecks. And after a recent quintuple bypass, Cussler's trying to carve out a new life without his longtime love. But he's not slowing down. The second half of his collection featuring cars from the 50s should open in Arvada next summer. And there's more writing, a children's book, and his first Western are on tap.
I'm not a dedicated writer like a Stephen King who finishes a book and starts the next one. You know, I go out and chase, look for an old car, and then I'll go look for shipwreck. And then maybe 6 months later, I'll start another book.
You just have so many interests.
That's it. There's almost too many.